Hello everyone, welcome back to Hardcore Minecraft. You know what? I completely, totally, utterly forget what the heck we were doing. What I was planning on doing. What I'm going to do. What needs to be doing. Ignore that last sentence because that just sounded really weird. I think we need more quartz crystal. I think. For here? We'll just take this out for the moment. I think we have to go to the Nether. Oops. And hunt down some more quartz crystal. I think. Yes? No, I have no idea what I'm doing. If anybody remembers, please let me know, because I can't remember my ideas right now. It has been a rather stressful time, as one can imagine. Okay. Well, it's been going on for about a month. Actually, a lot's been going on for a lot longer than that, but for most of that stress, I can deal with it, or dealt with it. And it didn't affect anything. This stuff, oi, jeez. Oh, hang on. No, those are stairs. Okay, where? Well, it's going to be nighttime, but that does not bother us for the situation. Inventory, please. We'll just sleep out the night. Oh no, forget about sleeping out the night. Let's just head to the Nether. Om nom nom. Oh, today I am being so lazy. Oh yeah. I'm slouching in my chair, which is bad for my back. I am just getting up the window open, got this nice breeze. Hopefully you can't hear too much noise. With the cars, you know, cars, stuff like that. And oh, what else? Nothing, just that. It's just a nice, lazy day. Oh, hiccups. Any quartz this way? We may as well go up here. Looking for quartz. And we found some. Okay, that appears to be it. Just doing some fast splunking, I guess. Okay. Well, okay. Although I do see some, so we're probably going to make our way down. Today is a Tuesday. And somebody's smoking another cigar. Well, at least that commented on that last night. At least it's not weed. Oh god, I hate that smell. Downside of living in an apartment with the windows open in the summer. If you're wondering if it's legal in Canada, as far as the last I heard, well, there's legal marijuana for medical reasons. That was actually a possibility of treatment. You can get it, usually it's given as in terms of the smoke, which is why we turned it down. Okay, I got totally disoriented. That loops around. Okay. Because we don't smoke in our household. Unless if it's food. There's also a pill that can be had. THC pill, which is the chemical component. But that's the only legal way. What has happened in Canada last I heard was it was decriminalized. Now what that means is if you walk down the street with an open beer, for example, you, the officer will take the beer, dump it out, and write you a ticket that you have to pay. That's it. Same kind of thing for marijuana if it is under a certain amount. Let's say you got a joint on you. We're not talking a Bob Marley joint here. Or a Cheech and Chong one. But, you know, just your typical average one. You'll be written a ticket where you pay a fine and they confiscate the item to be destroyed. That's it. I don't know what the exact weight is. If it's over that weight, it is considered trafficking. And that's a federal offense, and that gets into some more hairy things. Yeah, anyways. I got sidetracked. I have no idea what I was talking about before. I never finished this tunnel. I did see the, quartz on the way back. I shall grab it. So there you go. You got a little bit of a legal lesson for Canada. So, it is not that weed is legal. It's just it's been decriminalized if it's under a certain amount of weight. And you get to pay a fine. As if you had an open beer walking down the street. That's it. Simple, easy, clean. Clears up the courts. No problem. Okay, so no, that's regular stone. That was one of the issues. You get somebody with a joint and they had to be charged under the old law. They had to be charged under a federal crime, which was just tying up court's time. It's absurd. So whether I approve of drugs or not, I don't. It was pretty freaking stupid. It was just wasting so much time, so much money, creating horrible backlog and delays in, you know, like the idea of a speedy trial, all that kind of stuff. So this is a good compromise in my mind. There. That is enough to finish it off. Well, at least that one. Am I going the right way or wrong way? I think I'm going the right way. Yes, I am anti-drugs. And here beside me, I have hydromorphone. A synthetic morphine. Which, believe it or not, I was offered something in that family for my chronic pain with my doctor. I said I want to save that as a last resort. There should be other options available. And there were! We just didn't know of them. We needed a specialist who knew all that shit. Good, it's daytime. Can you tell I'm tired? I am really babbling about nothing. So, okay. So, we can have steps all the way down. I am happy with that. No, that's not what I want. I want this, and I need... Thank you. I like these kinds of steps, like with this particular material. It just really looks nice. It's the right kind of shade of what... It has more of a marble feel than the marble, quite frankly. So this is just wonderful. Could we do something a little weird with this build, maybe? What if we were to take a chunk of this land and turn it into kind of like a isolated tower? We have our one staircase up. And maybe have a rail that comes in underground. So what would happen is we would level everything. So let's say it would be a brick wall going up to the level of this around a certain amount of land. So we have kind of like our simple little cabin on top of an escarpment. It's a word that I want to say that's not clicking right now. Oh, we got some potatoes that we can replant. This is good stuff. Do we have a spot over here? No? Okay, all wheat. We'll put potatoes here. Excellent. How many seeds? I keep pressing escape. Mostly because of all the Stardew Valley I've been playing. We could build something like that. We could have a very large area. Could be interesting. Could be interesting. Would be a lot of work. We would have to bring it out to here just because of the way that we've done the entrance. If we were to do it, what would we do? Where would we start cutting the land? Here? So if we were to cut the land here and just go around and basically build a wall up. And have an oasis. If we do it right, we could have just cattle wandering around. Wherever they please to go. Could be interesting. We could do like a biodome. So we would build giant walls going all the way up with a glass ceiling. How does that sound? Could do something like that. Has potential. Has weird potential. Ow, my leg. Need to stretch. You'll have to let me know what you think. We could make a very large area completely enclosed, or at least very high walls, biodome locked in. Resources would be tight, but we can teleport. Let me know if you like that idea, or if you want something smaller. Yeah. I have done something like that before. I never quite finished the build, but I took an entire biodome. It was a jungle one, and completely enclosed it with a giant wall, and then I put a ceiling on it. And I was going to run tracks at all kinds of levels within it, and yeah. It was one hell of a build. I'm going to tell you that. It was fun. Really hard work. Where the hell? I got all turned around. Where the hell is that cave system here? Ah, here we go. Let's go this way. Thought it might be good to finally explore this. It's not the first time I've actually done a kind of build like that. Let's see. No, I've done two, but one was on a smaller scale. One was on a massive scale. At least for the size of biodome that I found. So yeah, we could do kind of like an arcology type thing, where the whole thing is enclosed. Or a chunk of it is enclosed. Let me know if you'd like to something like that to be worked on. It definitely takes time. And a lot of resources. This is definitely where something like renewable resources are so important to do a build like that. So the idea of not really using your coal, even though you always get a lot of it, but rather using your charcoal. Because you can continuously grow trees. Oh, that was a cow from above. Okay. Now, these kind of cave systems I like because they're so easy to follow. I hear a zombie. But not in this tunnel. Must be a connecting tunnel. Not a connecting, but an adjacent tunnel. Found it. That was the hardest part, I gotta say, about the one that I did on the smaller scale. I had to, within the dimension, I had to take walls right down to the bedrock to make sure that everything was enclosed properly. It was freaking hard. Ah, nighttime. Cow, you're supposed to be asleep. It's nighttime. I hear you. Okay, let's head out of here. Ah, shit, that scared the hell out of me. Nah! Sorry for the Skype comments. Friends having some troubles. Come on. I was on edge already. I didn't need that noise. Ow, that hurt. That hurt a lot. Oh, yeah, that's right. Coal can be turned into those coal blocks. Which is handy. Does it take 9? Or is it 4? It must be 9. Okay. We'll save up. Getting 9 stacks of coal and then doing it so you get a full stack of that. Definitely worthwhile. Especially if you plan to do a lot of smelting. Okay, yeah. You know, I think we will call it there. We've explored a little bit of a cave that's right by our home. And, please give me 2 seats. Oh. What? Oh, sneaky. Yeah, take that. Okay, that's a little better. Okay. Anyways, so, yeah, I think we'll call it there. Let me know if you like those ideas. Either a slightly smaller or a very large area that is completely and utterly enclosed except for our portal to get to the Nether and our other base. See if you like that idea. Now, if we do it, it will be a very slow build, either one. And it will certainly result in some sped up videos, just to be a fair warning. Because it is pretty monotonous. I've done it a couple of times, so I know. Anyways, I do hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you'll join me again for another installment to Hardcore Minecraft. But until then, please do be safe. Bye!